Assalamualaikum students and good morning to all of you. Hope all of you are doing great. So kids, welcome again. As you all know, my name is Nida Sahar and I am your social studies teacher. So today we are going to start our new chapter, chapter 4, our country. In this chapter, you are going to learn many interesting things about our country. The main points which we are going to discuss in this chapter are: what are borders, what is population, provinces, different landforms of our country, national language, game, flower, currency, etc. So let's get started. So kids, as you all know that the areas of land on the earth's surface are known as continents, and there are 7 continents. As you can see, this is the world map and there are 7 continents, and each continent has different countries. There are 193 countries in the world. Each country has its own language and its own customs. There are many people in the world, more than 7 billion. So kids, what is population? As I was talking about the number of people living in different countries, a population is the number of living things that live together in the same place. The population includes all individuals that live in that certain area. The people in a country are called its population. What is population? The number of people living in a country is called its population. Pakistan's population is over 207 million. Let's talk about the borders. Countries are separated from each other by borders. A border is a real or artificial line that separates two places. Borders are political boundaries. They separate countries, provinces, cities, and towns. Pakistan shares border with Iran in the west, Afghanistan in the northwest, China in the northeast, and India in the east. To the south is the Arabian Sea. Look at the map. At the top you can see this is the northeast, and here Pakistan shares border with China. Now at the northwest you can see there is Afghanistan. Here Pakistan shares border with Afghanistan. Now on the left side, this is the west, and in the west Pakistan shares border with Iran. On the right side, this is the east, and here Pakistan shares border with India. And to the south is the Arabian Sea. So kids, Pakistan shares borders with 4 countries: China, Afghanistan, Iran, and India. Now provinces. Kids, all of you know that there are 4 provinces in Pakistan. What are their names? Punjab, Sindh, Khyber Pakhtunkhwa, which is also known as KPK, and Balochistan. There are four provinces in Pakistan: Punjab, Sindh, Khyber Pakhtunkhwa, and Balochistan. The territory of Gilgit-Baltistan and Azad Kashmir is also administered by the government of Pakistan. The areas of Gilgit-Baltistan and Azad Jammu Kashmir is also administered by the government of Pakistan. So kids, now we are going to talk about the provincial capitals. Each province has a capital city, and let's see what are they. So kids, this is the map of Pakistan. It is showing the different provinces and their provincial capital cities, and the other territories like Gilgit-Baltistan and Azad Jammu Kashmir. So first, here you can see this is Balochistan, and the provincial capital of Balochistan is Quetta. Now Sindh, the provincial capital of Sindh is Karachi. Punjab, the provincial capital of Punjab is Lahore. KPK, the provincial capital of KPK is Peshawar. Gilgit-Baltistan, the capital provincial city of Gilgit-Baltistan is Gilgit. And Azad Jammu Kashmir, the provincial capital of Azad Jammu Kashmir is Muzaffarabad. And kids, do you know which is the capital city of Pakistan? The capital city of Pakistan is Islamabad. Right. So kids, which is the capital city of Pakistan? Islamabad is the capital city of Pakistan. It is the most beautiful city of Pakistan. Islamabad is the 9th largest city in Pakistan. Built as a planned city in the 1960s, Islamabad is noted for its high standards of living, safety, and abundant greenery. The city is known for the presence of several parks and forests, including the Margla Hills, as you can see in this picture. Now, the provincial capital of Punjab is Lahore. Lahore is the second biggest city in Pakistan. It is the capital of the province of Punjab. Lahore is also known as the city of gardens because of its many parks and gardens. This city is known for its rich culture and lively atmosphere. The provincial capital of Sindh is Karachi. Karachi is best known for being the business hub of Pakistan, and it is one of the most densely populated cities in the world. The provincial capital of Balochistan is Quetta. Quetta is famous for its honey sweet apples and many other varieties of fruit. For the abundance of fruit, Quetta is rightly called as the fruit basket of Pakistan. The provincial capital of Khyber Pakhtunkhwa is Peshawar. It is the biggest city of Khyber Pakhtunkhwa. It is also a cultural and economic hub of KPK. Peshawar is famous for its food and tourism, as it is one of the oldest city of Pakistan. The provincial capital of Gilgit-Baltistan is Gilgit. This city is located in a broad valley near the confluence of the Gilgit River and Hunza River. Gilgit is a major tourist destination in Pakistan and serves as a hub for trekking and mountaineering in the Karakoram Range. So kids, in the northern areas of Pakistan, there are high mountains covered with snow, deep valleys and dense forest, as you can see over here. There are various locations which are spectacular, but the top 5 tourist destinations in northern areas are Hunza, Skardu, Naran Kaghan, Kalam and Chitral. So these are the amazing and breathtaking northern areas in Pakistan. In the west and to the east of Pakistan are deserts. Deserts of Pakistan are dry and sandy places. The climate is dry and there is little rainfall. The main deserts of Pakistan are Cholistan Desert, Thar Desert, Thar Desert and Kharan Desert. In the south and in the center, the land is much flatter. The great river Indus and its smaller rivers flow through this part of the country. These are the plains of Pakistan. The land here is fertile. This means that crops can be grown over here. Different crops such as wheat, sugarcane, cotton and rice can be grown. Okay kids, let's watch an interesting documentary.
Pakistan, the land of 1,000 opportunities. Along with its rapidly growing economy and bustling heritage sites, it is home to a number of languages and cultures, as well as being the host to all 4 seasons and possessing a variety of terrains. Blessed with natural and historical riches, Pakistan's breathtaking destinations include magnanimous mountain ranges, rolling lush plateaus, all dotted with an abundance of pine trees and crystal clear waters to the north. Thank you. desolate yet alluring and expansive deserts towards the south. In between both extremes, it hosts countless mausoleums, mosques, gardens and lakes. Pakistan's agricultural sector has boosted the country's economy and continues to achieve high numbers of employment. Acres of fertile land, favorable weather conditions, and abundance of rain and rivers are further enhanced with a strong canal irrigation network.
So kids, sure you know that the people of Pakistan are called Pakistanis. The people living in different countries are their nationals. The people living in Pakistan are called Pakistanis. So kids, do you know who was the founder of Pakistan? Qaid-e-Azam Muhammad Ali Jinnah was the founder of Pakistan. He was the man who gave us this beautiful country, Pakistan. Okay kids, now it's your turn. You have to read the chapter, page number 18 and 19 thoroughly, and you have to underline the main points. And I'm sure after watching this video and after reading the chapter thoroughly, you would be able to tell which countries share a border with Pakistan, in which parts of the country do we have a coastline, how many provinces are there in Pakistan, can you name them, can you name the capital of Pakistan? Can you tell the provincial capitals of Punjab, Sindh, KPK and Balochistan? What is population? Okay kids, that is all for the today's lecture. In the next lecture, I am going to discuss the remaining part of the chapter. Okay kids, I am going to see you in the next class. Till then, all of you stay home, stay safe and study hard. Take care and Allah Hafiz.